In this tutorial, I'll be showing you how to create these metallic text effects in Adobe Firefly, and I'll also share a variety of prompts you can use. Stay tuned, and I'll show you how.
Studio Shepherd.
So in Adobe Illustrator, you can see I've pre-made my text, which is set to gold, but can be any color. I also have this in a 16x9 artboard, set to 1920x1080 pixels. So once you've done that, we can export this as a JPEG by going up to File, down to Export, Export As, and selecting JPEG, and make sure you tick Use Artboards. Then click Export, and you can copy these settings here. Then press OK. Now I'm also going to make another variation, as in this example, we want our text to have a rigid steel look. So to do this, we're going to select our text, go up to Effect, down to 3D Materials, and select Extrude and Bevel. Now in this menu here, we're going to scroll down to the Rotation dropdown, and under Presets, we're just going to select Front. And now back at the top, next to Bevel, click this toggle here to turn it on. And we're going to have our shape set to classic, bump the width right up to full, and you can adjust the other settings how you like. So once you're done, again, we're going to export this as a JPEG, and then we're going to jump across to Adobe Firefly. So open the text to image generator, and in this prompt bar, we're going to type in this prompt here. So forged iron ball with visible hammer indents, isolated on a white background, and then click generate, and it's going to create these four variations. Now we're just going to adjust a few other settings on the left hand panel here. So I'm going to change content type to photo, select hyper realistic, change the lighting to studio light, and the camera angle we're going to select shot from above. Now click Generate again, and now this is the look that we're trying to go for. So select one that you like, so I might select this one here, and click this pencil, and we're going to use this as our style reference. So that's going to edit on the left hand panel here, and now under our composition reference, click this thumbnail, and then select the text that we made earlier. So I'm going to open that, press continue. I'm going to make sure the strength slider is set to full. And I'm going to drop the visual intensity down to 0 and the strength of the style down to 0. Now I'm also going to change in the prompt, forged iron ball. I'm going to remove ball as we're now working with text. And I'm also going to change the aspect ratio to 16x9. Now, click generate, and it's going to create these awesome looking metallic text effects. Now I'm going to show you another example with a different prompt and different image. So in the prompt bar, this time we're going to use this prompt here, rusty metal ball, corroded edging, isolated on a white background. Then click generate, and following the same steps, we're going to update these settings on the left hand panel. And click generate again. And so I like the look of this one. So again, I'm going to use this as our style reference. And we're going to drop the strength and visual intensity down. Change the aspect ratio to 16x9. And this time for our composition reference, we're going to use the first text that we created, which was just our flat text. Open that. Bump the strength up to full, and now let's see how that looks. Oh, one more thing. We're going to remove ball from our prompt, and then press generate. Now it's going to create some cool, rusty-looking text. Now following the same steps, you can play around with the prompts displayed on screen to create different metallic effects. Feel free to play around with the prompts to create some new and unique looks. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to hit that like button and subscribe to stay up to date with the latest design tips. I'll see you in the next video.